Right, I was about to set up a new automation using Manychat for Instagram, and I thought, why not show you the process to set it up? So the automation is going to work like this. I will post a piece of content to Instagram, and I will use the call to action, comment something, and I'll send you the link. So the way that it works is that someone obviously comments that keyword, and the automation does two things. So one, it responds to their comment, and then two, it sends them a DM or a direct message, and it includes the link to the thing that I want. So Manychat is the tool that we use. Let's dive on in. Now, there is a free option. I am on the pro option. I think it's $15 a month. It's quite inexpensive, but you can do exactly what I'm going to do with the free version. So when you sign up, so head to Manychat. When you sign up, you'll need to connect up your account. So under settings there, we have channels. And so that is where I have connected up my Instagram channel there. I've also done Messenger as well, although I don't really use that like I do with Instagram. So then we go to the automation section on the left-hand side there, and we're going to create a new automation. Now, the really cool thing is that there's a whole lot of templates. So we don't start from scratch, we use a template. So the template we're going to use is this one here called Convert Your Instagram Comments into Sales. So we click on that one there. It gives us a little bit of a rundown of how it's going to work. So obviously comments, and then it sends the link. So we'll go set up template, and it looks a bit like this. So this is the workflow. So when a user comments on your post or your reel, that is the trigger. And then the next step in the workflow is the reply. So what we need to do is set up both of these steps in our automation. So the first thing we do is we click on this user comments on your post or reel. And on the left-hand side here, we can see we have some options. So in the free plan, you basically choose your post, so the piece of content that has that call to action in it, and that's what is the trigger. Now, because I have the pro plan, I can actually choose all posts or reels. The other option for your pro plan is the next post or the reel, but I quite like all posts or reels because it doesn't matter how many times I use this trigger, it's just going to keep on working in the background. So yeah, that's how we set up that trigger. So we choose either the post or all post, we hit continue, and then we create our keyword. So by default, it's added a keyword, which is checklist. I'm going to change that to society. So I'm using this to promote the Social Smarty Society. So it means that when anyone comments on any of my posts with the word society, that's what's going to be the trigger for this automation. Now, you can also choose to have keywords to exclude. So if someone says society, but they also say sucks, for example, the society sucks, I might not send them a DM. The other thing you can choose is any comment. I wouldn't recommend that because it's just going to spam people with your link. So we type in our keyword. Oops, we don't need it twice. Cool. And then we hit continue at the bottom there. And then it says that we need to set up some replies. So these will be the public replies that people see when they comment. So they comment the word society, and then this comment comes in afterwards. So it says, sent the link. Please check your DMs, sent you a DM. So we want to add quite a few in here, because obviously if we just have the same comment going out over and over again, it's going to look a little bit obvious that it's an automation. So I might say, sent the link, check your messages, and then a smiley face. So you obviously want it to sound like you as well. I think that'll do. So I've got four different in there. Obviously, I could get rid of or edit any of these ones here. And then we're going to click on save. Cool. Awesome. So that's our trigger. So anytime someone comments on any post or reel with the word society, they're going to get a random reply from these replies here. And that is our trigger. So now we need to go into the second step, which is what they actually get in their DMs or in their direct messages. So this is where we add in two things. We add our text, so we make it sound like us. So let's say, thanks for the interest. No, thanks for your interest. Your interest in the Social Smarty Society. Here's the link to check it out. So that's sort of how I would talk. And then we want to put the link in there. So the link for me is not that one. Get rid of that. So the link is going to be open website, and it's going to be, what would I put as the button there? Find out more. Oops. Hope if I can spell, find out more. And this is where we put our URL. So I'm actually just going to jump over and grab that from my website, which is whoops-a-days. Let's go. Socialsmedia.co/society. Let's double check that that's the right link. Yep, that's the one. So I'll copy that and I'll pop it into here. And I'll click done. So that is all ready to go. So we've got our trigger, we've got our response, and then all we need to do is turn it on. So we click over here to set it live, and that is ready to go. So now when we come back into our automations list, you'll see I've got quite a few set up. So I have one for webinar, which I ran recently, which I could turn off now. I have one for my Social Smarty Scoop, which is a series that I'm running on my podcast. I have one for my content planner. That one there, we're going to delete that because I think that was a mistake and that one's not live. And then this one here is convert your comments into sales. So I'm actually going to rename that one. I'm going to call it Society, so that when I see all of my automations, I can see which one is which. So hopefully that's useful. It's obviously a very common strategy on Instagram at the moment, but that is how you set up one of those automations.